Hello dear students, this is Rashid Khan and I'm going to explain you about MS PowerPoint. Before starting, please hit the subscribe button and also like this video. You may also share this video with your friends. First question that should be asked is, what is the use of MS PowerPoint? So I'm going to answer. MS PowerPoint is a presentation software which is used for creating presentation. What is presentation? Presentation consists of slides. These slides can contain images, text, sound, etc. And this can be considered as the basic unit of presentation, which are presented to the audience with the help of a projector or a computer screen. Getting started, I'm going to show you how MS PowerPoint is started on a computer system. I'm using the latest version of Windows, so I'm just going to show you. There are two ways to start MS PowerPoint. You type here PowerPoint and it will show the result. You just click on it and it will open. Second method is on the desktop, an icon should be created beforehand. You just click on it and this window will appear. This view, that is PowerPoint opens with a view. This view, it is known as the normal view, that by default it is a blank presentation only. Now we'll be dealing with the components of MS PowerPoint window. We'll be dealing with each one of them one by one. Okay, so first one is title bar. Here it is located. The title bar is at the top of PowerPoint window. It displays the name of the presentation on which we are currently working, and this name can be changed by the user only. On the left side of title bar, quick access toolbar is located. It contains a series of icons that are like save, undo, redo, etc. As the name suggests, quick access, for quickly accessing these options, it is located here. Next is slides pane. In slides pane, you can work directly on the individual slide. This is the slide pane. Then you can see these dotted borders, right? Dotted borders identify placeholders. There are two placeholders here, one and two. These can be moved and can be resized also. This, okay. So what you have to do is, you write the text here. Here it is written, click to add title and click to add subtitle. I'll show you in the upcoming slides. This one is the slides tab. This shows the thumbnail version of each full size slide. After adding multiple slides, different slide can be selected by simply clicking on it. Here, when you will select another slide, it will appear here only. These can be dragged to arrange it, and deletion and duplication is also possible. See here at the bottom part, here it is written, click to add notes. This is called as notes pane. Notes are written about the current slide. These notes come in handy when a user is giving presentation to a large audience, and the user can refer to these notes here only. Now I'm going to show you how to create a new presentation. For this, we are going back. This is the most basic version of the slide. By clicking on the new slide option, you can add multiple type of slides. Here few options are given, like title slides, title and content. Depending upon the requirement of the user, these slides can be added. I'm going to add title and content slide here. Okay, so in this way a presentation will be created. For running presentation, slideshow option is selected, and there is one shortcut key also, you can press F5 key. After creating the presentation, user can perform different editing in the slides. These editing options include inserting a new slide, duplication of a slide, adding text, deleting slides, and changing slide order. I'm going to perform these tasks one by one. First editing tool is inserting a new slide. This can be done in two methods. First one is by using a shortcut key, that is Ctrl plus M. We just press these keys together, Ctrl plus M, a new slide is added subsequently. Other method is you just click on new slide and select the type of slide you want. There is one more option of choosing the designs. To make your presentation look attractive, different designs are available in the MS PowerPoint. You can select whichever you want, okay. Next is duplicating a slide. Duplicating a slide simply means making a copy of existing slide. This can be done by two ways. You select the slide in slide tabs, go to new slides, and here one option is given, duplicate selected slide. I'm clicking on it. Another copy is created, that is slide number 2 and 3. Another method is by right clicking on this slide in the slides tab and select the option duplicate slide, and another copy of the slide have been created. Next editing tool is adding text. Two different boxes, dotted border boxes have been given here now. First one, this, click to add text, and click to add title. Here the text can be added. For example, I'm going to write the size and the indentation and alignment. Everything can be adjusted as you would adjust in MS Word. Next editing option is deleting slide. This can be also done very easily in the slides tab only. You select the desired slide you want to delete. Right click on it and delete option appears on the screen. You just click delete. One more way of deleting a slide is simply select the slide and press the delete button in your keyboard. Next is changing the order of the slides. The order of the slides can be changed very easily by just dragging and dropping. You select the slide you want to drag, and this little square box appears on the screen. Now you can move just by moving your finger, okay. The slides have been rearranged. The first has become second and second has become first, okay. So this is the end of the chapter. By the end of this chapter, the student must be able to answer how to create a new presentation. The student who are having computer system at their home can practice it, and then what are the different components of MS PowerPoint window you should know, and what is the use of placeholders, and how can you adjust the size of placeholders. This can be done by the students by going through this lecture. Now I'm going to end this presentation, and if you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment sections below. Okay. Thank you.